See there? That's the door we need to reach. And those annoying prefects would love nothing more than to rat on us to Scribner. So don't let them see us. Understood?
I can be sneaky. Let's go.
Hold on now. There's a spell you should know. The disillusionment charm. Good for getting places you're not supposed to be. Cast it and you'll appear as little more than a trick of the light, just as long as you keep your distance and stay quiet.
You mean I'll actually be able to turn invisible?
Something like that. It's not as foolproof as a cloak, but those are expensive. And spells are free. Give it a try.
If I can see you, the prefects might be able to as well. Be careful.
Blast! The librarian's still here. Quick, behind the bookcase.
You told me the librarian would be gone by now.
I said usually, but it'll still be all right. Do you see her desk behind me? The key is in the drawer of that desk. Now, here's what we're going to do. I'll create a distraction to draw her away. You focus on getting the key. I'll meet you outside of the restricted section.
You distract, I get the key. Understood.
I said I'd get you in, and I always keep my word. Trust me.
The key. Here it is.
Is someone there? Is that you, Peeves?
What are you up to now?
Oh, that one's charmed to look more useful than it is. It's fooled me twice. Never judge a tome by its cover, I say. Ghost, don't let her see you.
Revelio.
Should be in the clear. No need for us to be skulking about.
Revelio.
So what is it you've been looking for?
I'm looking for a cure to help my twin sister, Anne, so that she can return to Hogwarts. Because Merlin knows everyone else has given up.
Why do you think we'll find a cure in the restricted section? Hogwarts matron have nothing that can help Anne?
No! We've tried everyone from Nurse Blaney to St. Mungo's.
But I can reset right now.
Let's focus on
Revelio.
Which is what, precisely?
I'll know it when I see it.
You're being awfully cryptic. Secrets of the darkest arts. I'm impressed.
Revelio.
Levioso.
Revelio. Repairer.
They shouldn't be. Naughty, naughty. You'll get caughty.
Peeves, don't you...
I'm going to tell. I'm going to tell. I'm going to tell.
Oh, blasted Peeves. I've got to stop him or at least get to the librarian with a good excuse for all of this.
How do I know you won't go to the librarian and blame this all on me?
Why would I do that? I like having friends who are in my debt. Now go. Good luck in your search. Now, where has that damned poltergeist got to?
I know just the spell to repair this armor.
Repairer! Revelio. Of course, traces of ancient magic. There must be more to this one. That's it! Revelio.
Thank you.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Not surprising. Guards at the ready. Repairer. Accio. Levioso. This must be the way forward, but to where?
Yeah.
here. Let me also. Repairer. Nearly there. Best keep my wits about me. It is a book after all. Revelio.
You wanted to see me, Headmistress Fitzgerald, Professor Rackham.
Miss Isadora Morganach, welcome.
Prof Professor Rookwood, Professor Bacall.
We understand that you are adjusting well to life at Hogwarts.
I am.
I am glad. Especially in light of your unusual situation, starting as a fifth year.
As it happens, I was also admitted to Hogwarts as a fifth year. I've never heard of another like us.
Miss Morgan, when we spoke yesterday after class, you asked about the beautiful swirls you saw years ago when we visited your hamlet.
I recognized you all immediately. I cannot thank you enough for what you did.
We were glad to help.
And yes, I did see swirls of magic everywhere that day. My father insists it was my imagination running wild, but it was certainly real to me.
It was not your imagination.
Percival, Professor Rackham can see them too, but we have never known of another who could.
I don't understand. What are they?
The whispers or traces that appear when a particular form of ancient magic is wielded.
Ancient magic?
Few are capable of wielding it. Hogwarts itself is a stronghold of ancient magic.
So if I can see traces of ancient magic, does that mean I can wield it too?
With the proper training.
But let us not get ahead of ourselves, Miss Morganach.
Before I can train you to wield such magic, you must first master all that Hogwarts has to offer.
A magic this powerful can do great harm in the wrong hands. It must be wielded by a select few. As such, we ask that you not speak to anyone about what we have discussed here today.
Sebastian.
Sneaking in the restricted section again! I had thought we were through with this mischief. Clearly, detentions are insufficient. I'm afraid I must take this to the headmaster.
But that being said, Peeves informs me that you didn't come alone tonight. If someone has coerced you, I would have you tell me. You're a bright boy. Don't waste this.
There was nobody else. I came alone.
Oh, Sebastian. What will your uncle say?
Revelio.
You wanted to speak with me?
I did.
Hello, I'm Duncan Hobhouse. Pleasure to meet you. I've heard all about you, of course. Confronting trolls and dragons.
I suppose it must seem that way. I'm not sure it's justified. It's often been a matter of circumstance.
I'm going to presume your reputation is in fact warranted. In which case, you are precisely the person I need. You see, we were learning to repel boggarts in Professor Hecate's class, and, well, mine unfortunately took the shape of a puff scheme.
They're adorable. Why would you be afraid of a puff scheme?
They seem adorable until one sticks its tongue up your nose. Regardless of how reasonable I believe my fear of puff schemes to be, I'm beginning to get a reputation as a coward. Some have even taken to calling me Puffskeen Dunkeen.
I'm sorry to hear that. Words can be cruel.
Thank you. Poppy keeps offering to help me in overcoming my fear, but I'm too afraid to take her up on it. Anyway, to make matters worse, I stupidly blurted out that I must be braver than people think, since I have been in the Hidden Herbology Corridor.
The Hidden Herbology Corridor?
Yes. Rumor has it that the herbology professor before Professor Garlic kept dangerous plants there. It's supposedly so overrun now that no one dares enter it anymore. I was hoping you could go there and bring back evidence that I could use to show that, well, I'd gone in. Say a bit of an exceptionally dangerous plant of some kind.
What sort of plants should I expect in the Hidden Herbology Corridor?
I haven't a clue. But have you seen the kinds of plants Professor Garlic grows? If the previous professor was anything like her, I'd imagine they're not exactly harmless.
Very well. If I'm in the area, perhaps I shall take a look.
Grand. I'd very much appreciate it. Come and find me if you get the proof. I shall be forever in your debt.
Hidden Herbology Corridor. Sounds intriguing.
Now that I have all my gobstones back, I'm ready to take on all challengers. If I can find any. I really have made a mess of things.
Repairer. Accio. Levioso. Incendio. Is everything all right?
Oh, hello. Thank you for asking. I'm Cressida, by the way. And I'm afraid everything's not all right. I may be in a spot of trouble with the librarian. You see, I'm fond of creating my own charms. Thought I'd perfected my light as a feather charm to use on my library books. My arms get so tired carrying them around all day. But I must have confused the Latin word for feather with bird in my incantation, because when I opened my bag just now in the library, they literally took flight.
That sounds brilliant, actually.
Thank you. Somehow I don't think the librarian will see it that way. I collect the books and remove the charm myself, except this isn't the first time one of my charms has threatened the peace of the library. Armeet told Madame Scribner they were my books flying around, so she said that if I caused her any more trouble, she'd write to my parents. Perhaps you could get them for me. There are only five. She won't be suspicious of a new student looking around.
Why did Army tell Madame Scribner that they were your books?
Oh, to be perfectly honest, I don't think he meant any harm. I think he was impressed, bragging on my behalf. Amit spends a lot of time gazing at the stars, but he knows a good charm when he sees one.
I suppose I could help, if I have the time.
Oh, I'd very much appreciate it. One of the books is my diary. I'd rather it not fall into the wrong hands. If you could collect them and bring them to me, I can remove the charm.
I'm going to have to use Accio to get... Got it. Only four more to go.
Reading can be as magical as any spell. Why can't students see that?
Revelio. Lumos. Lumos. Revelio. the last book. Now to take them back to Cressida.
Revelio.
Reading can be as magical as any spell. Why can't students?
Leviosa. Revelio. Accio. Revelio.
Hello, Cressida. I collected your books, including your diary.
Oh, what a relief. Thank you. I'll happily take the heavy lot off your hands now.
Here you are.
Well, lesson learned. I certainly won't be practicing any charms in the library again anytime soon. Now, to work out where I went wrong. Perhaps I should start brushing up on my Latin. Thank goodness some people are trying.
That's it.
Everybody knows you're in remedial potions.
I suppose I'd be curious about the identification potion.
What? Not for me, Mogulai. For a friend of mine. Don't be stupid.
I'd like to see your parents' faces when they see your marks at the end of term. Perhaps you should work on your polyjuice potion so
is sharp and lively.
Revelio. 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 Incendio. Revelio.
These dry vines are one spark away from becoming kindling.
Incendio. Revelio. Accium. Levioso. Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. Accium. Lumos.
This must be the entrance to the hidden herbology corridor. Devil's snare seems to thrive in darkness. Perhaps it doesn't care for light.
Incendio.
That's cool. That does work a little bit, but it's definitely Lumos I need to do.
Lumos. Incendio. Lumos. Incendio. Lumos.
That's cool. This is cool.
Seems the devil's snare was protecting a chest of stone.
Rebellion.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Ooh.
Revelio. Lumos. Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos. I imagine a piece of that enormous venomous tentacular would be enough for Duncan to prove his bravery.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Revelio. Revelio.
Revelio. Revelio.
Guess I need to sell some shit.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look around. Very good. Never hurts to keep my stocks replenished. I hope to see you again.
Oh, that's cool. Too bad my wand doesn't match it. Shit.
What can I do for you today? Ah, dressed to impress, I see.
Thank you.
Have you found anything to, prove?
Hello, Duncan. I have the proof you wanted.
That's one leaf. Must have been a giant venomous tentacular. It's even more than I expected. I knew you were the one to ask. I appreciate you getting it for me.
Of course. I hope this helps you prove yourself.
This is sure to put an end to Puffskeen dunking for good when I show everyone in the common room tonight. This'll show Everett how ridiculous that nickname was. Thank you again, and have a good day. I know I will. Thank you for all of your help. No more Puffskeen dunking for me.
Like your pajamas.
Revelio.
Wow, they even commented on the pajamas I'm wearing. It's pretty good, man.
Serious. Goblins working with Rookwood makes no sense.
It is rather unorthodox, to say the least.
Unorthodox? It's inconceivable. It's... Ah, Fig. You have a visitor. I'll see what I can find out.
Sir, I was able to search the restricted section while you were with Professor Black. It was a book we were after.
What? That's... Wait. You accessed the restricted section? But how? Thinking on it, perhaps it's best you spare me the details.
Fair enough. In fact, the book was below the restricted section, as it appeared on the map.
I want to hear everything. First, let's have a look. Dear, some of these pages seem to be missing. It appears someone has got to the book before us. Still, I will need time to study what remains. Perhaps we can still salvage something useful, though it may take some time. I wonder why it was here, below Hogwarts.
I think I know, sir. I saw two more memories where I found the book.
Another pensive. Godric's heart.
The man we saw before, Percival Rackham, was a professor here. The first memory showed him and three other professors using ancient magic to restore a hamlet from a drought.
Miriam was right. And the second memory?
They were talking to a student who started as a fifth year, like I did. She could see traces of magic too.
Why those memories? Perhaps this book will explain. Now I'll have to take it with me to London. The headmaster has insisted that I speak directly to the minister about George's death.
What will you tell them about Mr. Osric's death?
I don't know how much I dare say. George tried to convince the ministry about Ranrock, but to no avail. My instinct is to follow the path we are on for the moment and keep the details to ourselves until we know more.
I understand. I'll see what I can learn about the missing pages while you're gone.
Good. Don't neglect your studies. Your wand work is improving by the day. But you'll want to pay attention in herbology and potions. There's more to magic than spell casting.
Plenty to keep me occupied while you're gone.
You've done exceptionally well. I look forward to seeing all that you've accomplished when I return. Oh, and don't neglect your friends. You may be surprised by how much you can learn from them as well.
Revelio. Accio. Incendio.
It's time to prove your dueling mettle and see if we've a new school champion. Beat me up.
Final round is
cross one. Also, the training dummy is still available.
Meet me in Lower Hogsfield as soon as possible. I would like to talk to you about Rookwood and Harlow, and it might be best to do so outside of the castle.
Professor Fig and Weasley have asked that I teach you an additional defensive spell. Please complete the assignments I have given you, and then proceed to see me in my classroom.
Champion coming through.
Hello, Lucan. I'd like to practice with the training dummy.
Excellent idea. This time will be a bit more of a challenge. Ready?
That'd be brilliant.
Wonderful. I'll set things up. Remember to cast all the spell combinations before the dummy lands again. If you need to stop practicing before you finish all of them, let me know. That's it!
Levioso. Accio. Incendio.
Good one!
Accio. Incendio.
Levioso.
Lumos.
Accio.
Incendio.
Impressive wand work. I'd hate to face you in a duel.
Thanks, Lucan. You've been a great help.
Oh, stop. Don't make me blush. Seriously, well done. Training dummies will think twice before challenging you again. Plus, you'll be even more formidable in crossed wands. Other duelists had better beware.
Hello, Lucan. Is the final round of crossed wands ready?
Big match today. It all comes down to this. the moment that we find out if your training and dedication is enough to win it all. Ready for a shot at glory?
I certainly am.
Brilliant. Are you dealing with a partner?
I'll go it alone.
Then let's get started.
We can make this a real victory.
That's the spirit.
Potato!
Incendio!
Act like a winner!
Accio!
That was nothing. I'm just getting started.
If the best duelists in the school weren't enough competition, then perhaps you should consider transferring to Durmstrang. Now, to the victor goes the prize! And so it is my great honor to present you with this simple yet elegant token of supreme dueling accomplishment.
Thank you. It's been an honor.
You earned it. You are a duelist to be reckoned with. Now that we've definitively crowned the tournament winner, I suppose I should get back to my schoolwork. Wonder how my herbology plants are doing. I haven't tended them in ages.
You can't be beat, can you?
Excuse me.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Good morning, Professor Garlick. How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear. Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie. Ah, hello. Class, please welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. How thrilling it is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bomb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with the mellifluous tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio. Let's see if we can't make our fibrous friends a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears. Now, everyone, grip their mandrake by the tendrils and give it a firm tug. Envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Reparo! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone! Now, for our next task, we'll be planting Dittany at our potting tables.
I wonder if hippogriffs like not.
I do wonder about Professor Fig. He's hardly ever in his classroom. Most strange.
Yes, Professor.
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
Actually, I enjoyed it. I couldn't help but catch your enthusiasm.
How kind of you. It seems you're already taking to herbology like a mandrake to fresh soil. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting Dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Pick them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the Magic Neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow. Let's see.
Oh, be right back.
My staff is an arrangement. Niffler's fancy.
Rebellion.
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganwen potion. And you also know.
Legendary cloak. Let me get that.
The best time to plant a seed is last season. The second best time is now.
Well done! Once it can be harvested, your Dittany will be ready to use in Wiganweld potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage. You'll find that some plants are better suited to uses outside of a cauldron. The cabbages do get testy without something to chew. Fortunately, I have a dummy for them to gnaw on. Be a dear, and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, And mind your fingers. They do bite.
Hello. Saw you on your way to Hogsmeade the other day. Nice to meet you. I'm Leander. I'll be showing you the Chinese chomping cabbages. Up these stairs will take us there. But your lead. Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian. And he's good. Thinks he's really good. But you outright slaughtered him. It was brilliant.
Oh. Well, thank you.
I nearly put Sebastian in his place myself. I mean, I would have, if Hecate hadn't stopped me.
Didn't she stop that dragon skull from crushing you?
Typical Slytherin trick, dropping a dragon skull on someone during a fight. We Gryffindors, here we are, home of the Chinese chomping cabbage. Go on, grab a few of those cabbages. Now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbages at it, and they'll do the rest. Mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out. Did save her the denoming, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? My kind of plants. Not like stupid booba tubers and bouncing bulbs. The kind of plants that'd have your back in a fight. Not saying you can't go it alone, but, well, imagine that wasn't a dummy.
Just because those cabbages will chomp on a dummy doesn't mean they do the same on, say, a goblin.
It's chaos out there. Trolls in Hogsmeade and such. You can't be above throwing a cruciferous vegetable if necessary. Dogweed and deathcap has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too. Ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
Reminder as to why we should always wear our dragon hide gloves. I shall end our lesson here. Terribly sorry, Mr. Clopton.
I tended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits. And good, as you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Magical plants have so much to offer. I'm eager to learn more.
I'm glad. Herbology is a bounteous subject. Tend to your garden, and it will tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Oh, those mandrakes are really relishing their new pots. Only cost me my damned hearing.
Source indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Be auras or someone from the ministry guarding the school after the incident in Hogsmeade.
Professor Black would never.
Revelio.
Potions is one of the most challenging and hazardous subjects taught at this school. As fifth years, you will be required to reach new heights of both discipline and intellect. You will begin this term by brewing a Wigan Weld potion. Mr. Takar, can you tell us why this particular potion might come in handy?
Yes, Professor Sharp. The Wigan Weld potion can be used to sterilize and even heal a variety of injuries.
It can heal some injuries, but not all. Points for Ravenclaw. Before today's class is completed, each of you will have brewed a Wigan Weld potion of your own. You never know when you might need it. Please begin. Use a strong, even motion when crushing your ingredients. Please be meticulous when adding powder to your potions. One errant sneeze could be disastrous. I see most of you have not forgotten how to stir. Not an easy potion to brew. Well done. And from what I hear of your recent exploits in Hogsmeade, you'd also do well to practice brewing the defensive Edurus potion. Professor Weasley had you acquire the recipe from J. Pippin's, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good. For the moment, you can find the ingredients you need in my office. But in the future, you'll be expected to provide your own ingredients. Some can be harvested from the plants you grow in your herbology class, and rarer ones can be purchased. Others, however, may be harder to obtain, and will require you to be a bit more resourceful. Come and see me when you've finished brewing, and we'll see if it was skill or luck the first time around.
Don't fret if you run out of ingredients. I simply grow most of what I need.
Professor Sharp said that...
My parents considered keeping me home from school this year after the rumors of a cult.
Did I hear Professor Sharp say that you have permission to go into his office?
Yes, but why does that matter to you?
Brilliant! And it matters because you can be a part of something truly creative. I'm Gareth, by the way. Gareth Weasley. Bit of a prodigy with potions, if I do say so myself.
Pleasure to meet you. Wait, are you related to Professor Weasley?
She's my aunt. Keeps too close an eye on me for comfort. Ugh. But she can't be everywhere. Listen, anyone with a troll-sized brain can brew an Edurus potion. I'm working on something that's certain to be spectacular. I'm just missing one tiny last ingredient that will add that extra spark.
I suspect that's where I come in.
You're as clever as I'd hoped. I simply need a single Fooper feather. As you'll already be in Sharp's office with his permission, perhaps you could grab it for me.
I don't know, Gareth. I don't want to get on Sharp's bad side.
You won't. Fooper feathers aren't that valuable. Sharp won't even miss it.
Very well. I'll bring you a Fooper feather.
Brilliant! Wait until you see what I'm brewing. Hurry back to me when you have the feather.
Revelio.
Your potion should not be that color, Miss McDowell.
Here's the flopper feather you wanted.
Brilliant! Thank you. This is going to take a moment to brew. You should get back to brewing your Endurus potion, and I'll tell you when this concoction's finished.
Proficiency in potions are two things that cannot be rushed. Have patience.
Revelio.
And now we add the mallow seed, and that's odd. What's happening?
My Wiganwell potion's utter rubbish.
Wait.
Professor Sharp must have learned a lot during his time as a...
Get it! Get it! Dragon Dog! What happened?
Well done, Gareth.
What now, Mr. Weasley?
Sorry, Professor.
That'll be points from Gryffindor. Again, Mr. Weasley did not do this on his own. His accomplice will answer to me as well.
I brewed an Endurus potion as you asked, Professor.
I'm surprised you had the time. You seemed rather busy helping Mr. Weasley brew chaos.
I'm sorry, Professor. I was merely trying to help a friend.
Taking responsibility for one's actions does go a long way with me. I shall assume that you've learnt a lesson. As for the work you did today at your own cauldron, I will say you've done well. I confess I was skeptical given the advanced nature of this class and the fact you're a new student.
I'm glad I was able to meet your expectations.
A rare occurrence. And you do well to remember that you're not a potions master quite yet. In addition to having a solid grasp of how to combine various ingredients, you should gain an understanding of the ingredients themselves. Pay particular attention in herbology. The plants you nurture there are often essential to the potions you brew here. Now, I recommend that you find a safe location in which to practice brewing. You cannot leave a hot cauldron simply anywhere. That'll be all. I think each of us has had enough excitement for one day. Class is dismissed.
I was impressed that you were able to answer Professor Sharp's question about the Wiganweld potion.
Oh, you're the new student. I've heard much about you. Thank you. I'm Amit, by the way. Pleasure, truly. And I've never seen anyone brew such a flawless Wiganweld potion on their first try. Well done.
I'm glad I was able to get it right the first time.
You must simply have a knack for potion making. Some students seem so confounded by potion recipes, it's as if they're written in gobbledygook. A fascinating language, by the way. Neither here nor there, really, but I am a self-taught speaker. Merlin's beard, good conversation is the enemy of free time. I must return my book, Gateway to the Far Stars, before my next class. Speaking of stars, we'll be in astronomy together. You'll love it. Professor Shaw is firm, but quite clever. See you soon, no doubt.
My robes are going to reek from Gareth's inspiration for the rest of term.
That was an interesting class.
Thanks to you. Wasn't precisely what I had in mind, but it was still brilliant. I appreciate your help. I hope Sharp wasn't too disagreeable when you handed in your potion. I heard him talking about taking responsibility.
Professor Sharp was annoyed, but we sorted it out. No harm.
Cheers to that. He probably had a good chuckle after we left. Sharp may seem gruff, but I'd bet a few galleons he blew up a potion or two in his day. Best be off. Next time we talk, I promise, fewer explosions.
Now, guess I'll slowly make my way to her.
It's a relief to finally what have an answer as to why that portrait was
empty. I swear to God, I thought I saw a flying book. Guess I was just tripping.
Seems an odd choice for wandering about outside your dormitory.
Revelio.
Do you happen to have any valerian sprigs?
Incendio.
When am I gonna get my broom?
Revelio.
What's up here?
Revelio. Lumos. Accio. Revelio.
Heard you're defending Hogs. You know, there is such a thing as trying too hard.
It's a classroom.
Accio. Accio. Leviosa. Revelio.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Leviosa. Accio. Incendio. Revelio. Revelio. Lumos. Levioso.
Accio.
Levioso. Incendio. Accio. Levioso. Accio. Revelio.
Some assistance.
Hello, can I help you?
Oh, thank goodness. Yes, my name is Grace Pinch Smedley of the Bath Pinch Smedleys. I was hoping someone would come along soon. I was about to defy my father's wishes and would never have forgiven myself. You see, I need to retrieve something from the bottom of the lake. Might you be the one to help me?
Diving into the lake sounds like an adventure. Tell me more.
Splendid! Precisely the response I'd hoped for.
What do you need help retrieving?
Years ago, my grandfather, who fancied himself quite the astronomer, set sail from Hogsmeade Station for what was meant to be a quick stargazing cruise with my grandmother. They never returned.
I'm so sorry. What happened to them?
We can't be sure. We only know that neither they nor their boat made it back to shore. They were presumed drowned. Father was so distraught that he forbade our family from setting foot on or in the Black Lake ever again. A treasured family astrolabe vanished with them that night. If you could dive down and retrieve it, I may be able to bring my father some peace.
What exactly is an astrolabe?
It's an astonishing ancient navigational tool. Essentially, a handheld model of the universe. It's mainly used for studying the stars, astronomical pursuits, but it has nearly 1,000 uses. Fascinating device. Sadly, I'd imagine it's rusted beyond repair now. Still, we'd love to have it returned to us. It would be like getting a bit of my grandparents back.
You seem to think I might have heard of the Bath Pinch Smedleys. Why would I know your family?
That's like asking why the sky is blue or grass is green. The Pinch Smedley name is synonymous with intellectual curiosity. We are known for our contributions to science and art. I'm surprised you haven't heard of us, frankly. But with all I plan to discover about the world around us, those that don't yet know the name certainly one day will.
It sounds dangerous, especially for something of mere sentimental value.
I understand. But I'd be forever grateful. Of course, you may discover much more than the astrolabe. Anything else you found would be all yours. I've cross-referenced the vessel's last alleged location against the lake's topography, depth charts, and tide schedule. My best guess is that it's just over there, about a furlong from the dock. It would be wonderful to have my grandfather's astrolabe back. I do hope you find the astrolabe. It would mean so much to our family.
It sounds as if her astrolabe is just northeast of the dock. I should dive down and see.
I never thought Ramrock's loyalists would go this far.
It is good to see you, my friend.
Revelio. Pardon me, is everything all right?
Hardly. I've just lost my business and almost my life. You'd best look elsewhere for wares. I've nothing to sell now. I never thought it'd come to this. Be on your guard. Ranrok and his loyalists will spare no one.
They attacked you.
Oh, Ranrok has no patience for goblins who won't join him. While I too would like to see goblin kind treated by wizards as equals, bloodshed is not the answer. When I said as much, they turned on me, struck me till I nearly passed out. Took my carts, my belongings, even that which is most precious to me, my paintings.
Has Ranrok's lot ever attacked you like this before?
They've been taunting and threatening me for a while now. They've always believed that violence is the only way to get what they want. Things have taken a much darker turn of late. Ranrok is getting more powerful, and his loyalists know it. They feel untouchable. Ranrok assumed that all goblins would agree to follow him, but he was wrong. Many of us would like a diplomatic end to the discord with wizardkind.
You mentioned that your paintings were taken.
I am. It's my calling, though most would think it an unusual path for a goblin. Most of my family work in metal, or associated with Gringotts. I'd wager my finest brush that Ranrok's lot have no appreciation for any of my work, and it'll be tossed aside for kindling. Without my carts and my livelihood, who knows when I'll be able to paint again.
I'm sorry this happened to you. I shall certainly keep an eye out for your carts.
That is very kind of you, but I think they took them to their camp southwest of here, just past some ruins. Too dangerous to try and retrieve them. I did enchant the carts to return to me if I ever lost them, however. Slim though the chances may be, I'm holding out hope that some of what was taken is returned to me. It was nice meeting you. I wish it had been under better circumstances.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this. After what Ranrok did to that goblin banker at Gringotts, I shouldn't be surprised at what happened to Arn.
Are you walking in your sleep, or did you just forget to get dressed?
Revelio. This must be where the Pinch Smedley family astrolabe is. I should let Grace know that I found her family astrolabe.
What a mask.
Thank you.
find the dive too terribly difficult.
Hello, Grace. I followed your bearings on a dive in the Black Lake.
Oh, how incredible! Did you find the astrolabe?
I did. I hope it makes your father happy.
It will. I can't wait to see his face. Thank you so much for doing this for me, and for my family. You do well to keep an eye out for more spots to dive. A diver of your caliber is certain to find all sorts of things down there. Thank you again. You keep diving. You certainly have a knack for finding treasure.
Hello, sir. What do you sell here?
Hello. I'm Jalal Sami, and this is my potion shop. I can answer any questions you have about the town.
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? Ah, yes. A wonderful choice. I'll have no trouble selling this. Thank you. I hope to see you again sometime.
Hello, Mr. Sami.
What can I do for you?
Can you tell me a bit about yourself?
Oh, let's see. Well, I am Lord Hogsfield's preeminent potioneer. And I was once a lowly Hogwarts student like you. In fact, I'll give you the Hogwarts discount. It's the standard price. My price is a low enough already, you see.
What do you have for sale?
I sell only potions and their ingredients. If you can't fix it with a potion, then it's best left broken, I say. My ingredients are all local to this area, and my potions are brewed to keep you healthy and safe.
Any whispers going about the town?
There's a thief on the loose by the name of Katrin Haggerty. She's an Ashwinder. She's stealing everything that's not nailed down, and people have had enough. Katrin's hiding in a camp just southwest of town.
That will be all. Thank you for your time. After what Ranrok did to that goblin banker at Gringotts, I shouldn't be surprised at what happened to Arn.
Revelio! Revelio! Revelio.
shame you're so foul.
Revelio.
Past the ruins. I'm on the right track. An encampment. This must be it. As if there's more than one way to enter.
Arn will regret not joining us. He doesn't come round now. He'll be made even more of an example.
If only I could get my hands.
Should have killed that Arn. Took his cards.
Petrificus totalis. Revelio. You are there.
Potato!
I don't have time for this!
Accio!
You can't!
Something. Now, to free Arn's cards.
Revelio.
Quite an enchantment. The cards are returning to Arn.
Levioso.
Thank you.
Accium.
Levioso. Revelio. Incendio. Levioso. Accio. Revelio. Levioso. Accio. Revelio. Incendio. Revelio.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Wonder who lives here.
You're here for my wares.
On, I have good news. Your carts are on their way back.
I don't know what to say. Any hope I have of getting my belongings back was quickly fading. Ranrock's lot called me a fool for believing in the good in wizard kind. Thank you for proving them wrong.
I managed to free your carts fairly easily.
Oh, I'm glad you're all right. Oh, I can't wait to have my things back, especially my paints. You know, you've inspired me. I've been dealing with witches and wizards for years, and we've always got along just fine. Perhaps my next piece will be a tribute to all that is good between us.
What a nice idea, Ron. I wish you luck with it.
Oh, I can't wait to get started. Thank you again for all you've done. All the best to you. Once my cart's arrived,
your attire is definitely unique.
Nice. Time to save.